Hello students, I am your biology lecturer. Welcome to the biology class. In the previous class, we completed the chapter Cell, the Unit of Life. Okay, here I am going to give some important question. I will answer for all the 1 marks questions. I will give some 5 marks question also. Please write the answers in a separate notebook. Okay, please write the answers for each and every question. It is very important, student. Okay, we will start now. First question for 1 mark. Here you can see the chapter name, Cell Unit of Life. Okay, the important questions, 1 mark questions. First question, what is prokaryotic cell? Okay, the prokaryotic cell is the one type of cell. It doesn't have any nuclear membrane. The cell doesn't have nuclear membrane, or we can write like this, prokaryotic cell have the scattered genetic material. The genetic material is scattered without any nuclear membrane. Okay, then the examples for prokaryotic cells are the mycoplasm, bacteria and viruses. Next, what is eukaryotic cell? Eukaryotic cell have the proper covering or proper envelope for the genetic material, that is the nuclear membrane. The well defined nucleus is present. Such type of cells are known as a eukaryotic cell. Okay, I am answering 3 types of answers. Means first we can write like, eukaryotic cells are the types of cells which having envelope for the nucleus. Okay, the eukaryotic cell have the well defined nucleus. Second one, the eukaryotic cells have the covering for nucleus. Okay, example, all the plants and animal cells are the eukaryotic cells. Then what is nucleoid? The genetic material which is present in the prokaryotic cell, it is scattered, it is known as a nucleoid. The genetic material without any nuclear membrane, it is known as nucleoid. Example, you can write bacteria. First one we answered, second one, then third one. Next question, what is chromatin? Chromatin is a genetic material present inside the cell which having DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, then what is mesosome? Mesosome is a enfolding of the plasma membrane in case of prokaryotic cell which are having the enzymes necessary for respiration. Okay, while explaining the structure of bacteria, I explained each and every steps. Don't forget that. If you have any doubt, means you can go and watch the previous videos, then your doubt will be clear. Next, we already complete that, mesosome. Then next question, what is which is the longest cell? First question is, which is the largest cell? While explaining the shape and size of the cell, I told that example for largest cell, the largest cell is the egg of ostrich. Okay, then next question, which is the longest cell? The longest cell is a nerve cell. Nerve cell is a longest cell. Then next question is, which is a smallest cell? Smallest cell is a mycoplasm. Okay, it is around having 0.3 micrometer in length. Then next one, what is the shape of RBC? What is the shape of RBC? RBC in the sense it is red blood cells. Kempu rakta kanagalu. In Kannada we can say. Then what is, question is, what is the shape of RBC? The shape of the RBC is biconcave shaped RBCs is present. Okay, then next question, what is the composition of plasma membrane? Plasma membrane is made up of lipid, proteins and carbohydrates. Lipids are mainly glycolipids or the phospholipids. The structure of plasma membrane is explained by the model, that is fluid mosaic model. Okay, next question, what is glycocalyx? In case of some bacterias, addition to the cell, after the cell wall there is a loose layer is present, that is known as a glycocalyx. The glycocalyx is just surrounding the cell wall and it having the protective function. Okay, the next question is, what is plasmid? The plasmid is extra chromosomal circular DNA. In case of bacteria and some eukaryotic cell organelles, the structure, it is usually circular in shape and it is having DNA. It is extra chromosomal circular DNA. What is the function of plasmid? Plasmids are having the antibiotic resistant genes, which protects the bacteria from antibiotics. Then, what is capsule? Capsule is a kind of glycocalyx. When the glycocalyx is loose sheath, it is known as a, sorry, when the glycocalyx is made up of thick and tough sheath, it is known as a capsule. Glycocalyx yavaga thick aagirutto rough aagirutta avaga nam en heltivi, instead of using the word glycocalyx we can say that is a capsule. The capsule is present in some bacteria. Next question, what is slime layer? In some bacteria, the glycocalyx may be loose sheath. It is known as a slime layer. Okay. Next, what is flagella? Flagella is one of the locomotory structure, or we can say that the flagella is a filamentous extension from the cell wall, helps for movement. Okay. Then, what is pili? In some bacteria, along with the flagella, some other surface structures are arise. Those are known as a pili, which help for reproduction. That's why it is known as a sex pili. Okay. Next important question, that is, what type of ribosome is present in case of prokaryotic cell? In case of prokaryotic, the answer is, in case of prokaryotic cell, the 70S type of ribosome is present. You must and should concentrate on the types of ribosomes. In which cell, which type of ribosome is present, that is so important, student. Okay? Then, the answer is, in case of prokaryotic cell, the 70S type of ribosome is present. Okay, then what is polyribosome? Polyribosome we can see in case of cytoplasm of the prokaryotic cell. A single mRNA which is going to bind with the many ribosomes. One day one mRNA balastu ribosome band aktavala, that structure is known as a polyribosome. this polyribosome condition we can see only in case of the bacterias or prokaryotic cell. A single mRNA is binded by the many ribosomes. Then, what is inclusion bodies? The inclusion bodies are the structures which stores the reserved material in the prokaryotic cell, in the cytoplasm. Then, next question, what is protoplasm? Protoplasm is a fluid in the cell which consists of cytoplasm plus nucleus. The cell except plasma membrane is considered as a protoplasm. Okay, next question. These are the questions here. We already completed. Next question. What is cytosol? A cytosol is a pure fluid inside the cytoplasm which consists of water, salts, protein, carbohydrate, lipids and enzymes. Cytosol means only the liquid contained in the cytoplasm except cell organelle. Cytoplasm minus cell organelle is known as a cytosol. What is extrinsic protein? Extrinsic protein, in the sense, it is a protein which is present in the external surface of the plasma membrane. The proteins which are attached. Next question is, what is the composition of cell wall? The cell wall, which is made up of three components like cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin, and some proteins. Cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. Okay, next. What is middle lamellae? Middle lamellae act as a cementing material which is present in between the primary wall of cell wall. It is made up of calcium pectate. It act as a cementing material. Okay. Then, next question. You can add here, what is plasmodesmata? The plasmodesmata is a connection between the two cells which is present in the plants. In case of plant cells, the cell wall is connected with the neighboring cell with a connection known as a plasmodesmata. Okay. Next question is, what is cisternae? The next question, question number 29, that is, what is cisternae? The cisternae is the structure or a small sac-like structure which is present in the Golgi complex. It is known as a cisternae. Okay. Then, next question is, what is the function of Golgi complex? Sorry students, what is the function of Golgi complex? The function of Golgi complex is, packing of the material for the transportation. Okay. Instead of writing the question, I wrote the answer only. What is the function of Golgi complex? Golgi complex function is packing of the materials and transportation. Okay. Then, what is endoplasmic reticulum? The endoplasmic reticulum is the one of the type of cell organelle which helps for the synthesis of proteins and the lipids. Okay, next, I didn't mention here, I will write the questions related with the endoplasmic reticulum at the end of 1 mark questions. Okay, here the next question is, which cell organelle is called as a powerhouse of the cell? It is very important question. The powerhouse of the cell is mitochondria. The mitochondria is known as a powerhouse of the cell. It have the reason like it synthesizes the energy in the form of ATP. That's why it is known as a powerhouse of the cell. Then, what is the function of mitochondria? In the previous question only, we answered for the this question. In answer for this question, what is the function of mitochondria? Mitochondria synthesizes the energy in the form of ATP, or it stores the molecular energy in the form of ATP. Then we can write, the mitochondria is a site for aerobic respiration. That's why it is known as a powerhouse of the cell. Then, what is cristae? Don't get confused with the cisternae and cristae. Cisternae comes in the topic of Golgi complex. Cristae will come in the topic of mitochondria. Cristae is the infoldings of inner membrane of the mitochondria, is known as a cristae. Okay, next question, what is the main function of mitochondria? This is the repeated question, don't consider this one. Next question, which type of ribosome is present in the human mitochondria? In human mitochondria, 55S type of ribosome is present. 55S, remember they mentioned in case of human mitochondria, 55S type of ribosome is present. Next, what is oxysome? Oxysome is a structure which is present in the cristae. It is present on the cristae. The oxysomes are the pin-headed particles, or the small particles which are present on the cristae, which are having F1 and F0 particles, which are necessary for the formation of ATP. Those are known as the oxysomes or the Racker particles. Oxysome andru vande, Racker particles andru vande, F1 and F0 particles andru vande. Then next question is, what is plastid? Plastids are the types of cell organelles which are having pigments for specific color to the plants. Plastids are the cell organelles which are present in the plants only, which bears the pigments which are necessary for color, specific color to the plant of the different parts. Next question, what is chloroplast? The chloroplast is the one of the plastid which having the pigment that is chlorophyll and carotenoid, which is very necessary for photosynthesis. Then next question is, what is leucoplast? Leucoplast is a type of plastid which doesn't have any pigments. Instead of that pigments, it stores a reserve food material, or it stores a nutrients. Leucoplasts are, we can say that, colorless plastids. Okay, then next question, what is chromoplast? Chromoplast are the types of plastids which contains keratins and xanthophylls and other pigments, which gives yellow, orange and red color to the different parts of the plant. Next question, what is amyloplast? Amyloplast is the one of the type of leucoplast which stores carbohydrate or starch. Next question, what is ileoplast? Ileoplast is a one of the type of leucoplast which stores oils and fats. Amyloblast means stores the starch or carbohydrate. Ileoplast which stores the oils and fats. Next question, what is alluroplast? Alluroplast is a type of leucoplast which stores protein. Next question, where the porin proteins are present? The porin proteins are present on the membrane of chloroplast. What is stroma? Stroma is the fluid or matrix present in the chloroplast, or matrix of the chloroplast is known as a stroma. Matrix of chloroplast is known as stroma. Remember, here I am going to mention that extra questions. What is function of RER? What is the function of SER? These are the types of endoplasmic reticulums. RER in the sense, what is RER? RER antandra rough endoplasmic reticulum. The rough endoplasmic reticulum necessary for the synthesis of protein and steroidal hormones. Next question is, what is the function of SER? SER in the sense, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, which doesn't have any ribosome on it. Ribosome irudilla anta rough endoplasmic reticulum ge naven heltivi, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. These are necessary for the lipid synthesis. Okay, then next question is, what is thylakoid? Thylakoids are the structures, sac-like structures, which are present in the chloroplast stroma. Sac-like structures which are present in the stroma of the chloroplast, those are known as the thylakoids. Okay, then next question, what is grana? Grana, many thylakoids in the chloroplast arranged one above the other to form a structure called as a grana. Grana is a combination of many thylakoids or arrangement of thylakoids one above the other to form a structure, grana. Okay, next important question, where the chlorophyll pigment is present in the chloroplast? The chlorophyll pigments and other pigments are present in the thylakoid lumen. Lumen of thylakoid having all the pigments. Thylakoid space irthadala adana en heltivi lumen anta heltivi. Inside that lumen all the pigments are present. Next, what is the function of chloroplast? Chloroplast is very necessary for the photosynthesis. Next question, what is lysosome? What is lysosome? Lysosome is a one of the cell organelle which is known as a suicide bag of the cell, which consists of many hydrolytic enzymes. It is a small sac like structures which consist of many hydrolytic enzymes known as a lysosomes. Next question, what is vacuole? Vacuole is a membrane bond space found in the cytoplasm. Membrane bond space found in the cytoplasm is known as a vacuole. Okay, next question, what is tonoplast? Tonoplast is a membrane of vacuole, a single membrane present in the vacuole is known as a tonoplast. It is very important, student. Then what are contractile vacuoles? The contractile vacuoles are usually present in case of amoeba, which are necessary for excretion. Contractile vacuoles, which are very necessary for excretion, which are present in case of amoeba. Okay, next one, what is exonema? Exonema is a core material present in the cilia and flagella, which having microtubules is known as exonema. Exonema is a core material which is present in the cilia and flagella. Okay. Next question is, what are radial spokes? The radial spokes are the structures which joins the peripheral microtubule with the central sheath in case of exonema. Okay. Then next question is, where we can see a 9+2 arrangement or array? The 9+2 array we can see in the cilia and flagella. The 9 doublets of peripheral microtubules and a central, a pair of microtubules. Next question is, what is whiplash flagella? A whiplash flagella is when the lateral hair-like structures are absent, means the surface of the flagella is smooth. Such type of flagellas are known as whiplash flagella. Okay. Next question is, what is tinsel flagella? In case of tinsel flagella, the tinsel flagella bears a lateral hair-like structures, or we can say those hair-like structures are the flimmers. Next question is, what are centrioles? And write the functions. The centrioles are the granular cylindrical bodies which are present in the centrosomes. The function of the centriole is synthesis or the formation of spindle fibers during the cell division. During the cell division, synthesis of the spindle fibers. Next question is, what is nucleolus? Next question is, what is nucleolus? Nucleolus is a granular structure which is present in the nucleoplasm, which is a site for rRNA synthesis. rRNA synthesis takes place in the nucleolus. Next question is, what is perinuclear space? Perinuclear space in the sense, in between two nuclear membrane there is a gap known as a perinuclear space. Then next question is, what is nucleoplasm? Nucleoplasm means is the matrix of nucleus. Then next question is, what is genome? The haploid set of chromosome or haploid set of genetic material is known as a genome. Next question is, what is metacentric chromosome? Metacentric chromosome is a type of chromosome which consists of the centromere in the middle. Next, what is submetacentric type of chromosome? Submetacentric type of chromosome is a one of the type of chromosome which consists of the centromere slightly away from the center. Then what is telocentric chromosome? Telocentric chromosome in the sense which consists of the centromere near to the terminal, near to the tip. Next question, what is acrocentric chromosome? Acrocentric chromosomes are the type of chromosomes which consist of the centromere at the tip regions. Next question, what is centromere? In case of chromosome, two chromatids are joined at the common point known as a centromere. Then next question is, what is telomere? a telomere in the sense it is the tip of the chromosomes. Next question, what is microbodies? Microbodies are the sac like structures filled with the enzymes which are necessary for the physiological activity in the cells. These are all important questions which we can expect from the chapter cell unit of life. Okay, totally I gave 73 questions, nearly 72 one marks question. These questions are very important. I think I skipped some more questions. What is phycobilin? What is centromere? What is chromatid? I skipped those questions. What is nucleopore? What is function of nucleolus? Everything I skipped because it will come for the 5 marks questions. Okay, please practice and prepare answer for all the questions. These are very important questions. If you skip reading the chapter, you can read this much of questions. It will enough for the reading full. It will equal to the reading of whole chapter. Okay, that's why students, please prepare answer for all these questions. These are very important questions. It will come for the final examinations. Okay, this is all about the one mark questions. In the next class, I will give some 5 marks question, important questions. I am not going to explain the 5 marks question in the video class. Just watch the previous regular class, previous videos, and write the answers. Okay, we will continue in the next class.